Hey guys, this is Michael from teenstech.com, and here we have a quick review of the new Nexus 7. As you can see, the Nexus right there. This is Google's latest entry in the tablet market, upgrade from their previous Nexus 7, which we've got right here. And this device starts at $229. It has a quad-core Snapdragon S4 Pro processor. It also is pretty thin at 8.65 millimeters thick, with a full 1080p display at 7 inches and diagonally. The exact same display, other than the resolution and quality. Size-wise, the same display as the previous Nexus 7, and a bit smaller than the iPad Mini. It also has a 5-megapixel back camera, which was not in the previous Nexus 7, and a better front megapixel camera. I believe it's like 1.5, whatever it might be. It's better than the previous generation. Supposedly not as wide, but in resolution-wise, it is better. It's much slimmer, as I said, 8.6 millimeters. You can see right here that it's pretty thin compared to the 10 millimeter thick Nexus 7 older generation. It's much taller. The bezel up top and bottom are taller than the bezels on this device, but the bezels on the side are much, much thinner, so you can grasp in your hand much more easily. We'll have to work hard to hold it here. It's much, much easier. Footprint-wise, it's smaller, but as I said, the bezels top and bottom are larger, and height-wise, it is taller, but much... So I'm going to show you. But much, much less wide. Display is gorgeous. Full 1080p panel, especially the highest resolution 7-inch device. It really looks good. I'd say it's better than the iPad 4 in regards to kind of crispness and color reproduction. It just looks really, really good. You kind of see. Let's see if I can even focus on that. But you really, if you go on, like, you can see you can't actually discern any pixels. Which is pretty crazy compared to the old one, which was really bad at 720p. Let's see, there we go. So that's the kind of the biggest hardware changes. We have a stereo speakers now, top and bottom down here. So you kind of get the whole stereo sound. When you hold it like this, because you have these nice bezels, the sound will then go from your hands to your face, which is quite nice. And this is running Android 4.3, which is Google's latest version of Jelly Bean. It's their third version of Jelly Bean, I believe, from 4.1 to 4.2 to 4.3. This version of Jelly Bean includes better support for multi-users, as well as speed improvements, and enables some other cool randomness. It isn't really, really big. We also have... Pretty much, a new camera. I can show you that, which is entirely one finger settings. You can reach to whatever you want with a single finger and then press shoot, take a picture, that's it. And that's easy. Other than that, there really is no big improvement. You get some Wi-Fi changes. There's more developer side, but I've got some Wi-Fi changes you get in the advanced area. We get some, where is it? Scanning always available, which means you get Wi-Fi scanning even Wi-Fi's off, as well as I think better optimization for battery life in regards to Wi-Fi, and that's about it. There's really no big changes UI-wise at all, but everything feels pretty snappy. Things open up super quickly. Whoops, that's bad. Oh, crash. There we go. Things open up really quickly, as you can see. Chrome, you can really explore web pages. Once they load very fast. Switching apps is a breeze. Compared to the old Nexus 7, this is pretty much a beast. And it's just really, really fast and really, really crisp. So you can see everything is pretty responsive. Typing on here is really nice. It's super, super, super quick, which is quite nice. Altogether, this is a really, really, really great device. Like, I found nothing wrong with it. It has wireless charging, so I leave it next to my bed charging. It's super snappy, rarely crashes, as you saw before. It did crash, but it rarely does that. It gets updates right away for $229. It is actually, I'd say, the fastest tablet I've used other than the iPad 4, but definitely the fastest Android tablet I've ever used. Screen looks gorgeous. Watch a movie looks great. Let's watch a movie, actually. And everything just works really, really well. And of course, it's Chromecast compatible. It's pretty great. And what's really cool as well is Netflix enables for full 1080p output. So you can actually watch full 1080p videos. If this is actually to load, that'd be quite nice. Let's see. Let's watch Ice Age and see if it works. You know what? Let's just try something else. So we also now have support for GP or ELS 3.0, which is the new GL, OpenGL version 3.0, which enables for better graphics. So if you want to play a game, this is one of their newest games, Riptide GP 2. This is by Vector Unit, and it's second edition of the GP Riptide game. There we go. As you can see, once I went past that thing, it loads pretty quick. And the graphics are really, really great. Once it loads, of course. You can hear the sound. Sounds pretty good. So let's do a game. And you'll see the graphics just look great. I played for a solid 4 hours of this game with full brightness and battery still lasted. So really, I mean, it is definitely great graphics-wise. Everything that looks really, really good. And it's snappy. But yeah, I would totally recommend this device. It works pretty well. For $229, I would buy it right now. I'd buy multiple of them. It really is a great device. Now, one issue could be with the first Nexus 7, there were some issues a few months after you bought it where it started to slow down. Hopefully that will not happen again. That was supposedly due to some solid state issues with Android 4.1 and 4.2. This thing now enables trim support, which supposedly helps with that, and it will speed up the old Nexus 7. But hopefully this is not the durability of this device is not only a year. Hopefully it'll last longer than that. And hopefully the current Nexus 7 or the previous Nexus 7 will speed up as software improvements occur. But we'll find out. So I definitely buy this device. It works really well. It's fast. It feels good. And I would definitely go out and buy one. It's available on Amazon, Newegg, Staples, Barnes & Noble, GameStop, and of course the Play Store with free shipping. It's also available in 32 gigabytes as well as LTE. The LTE version works on almost all LTE networks, including Verizon, AT&T, T-Mobile, as well as possibly Sprint. But that's pretty great, especially in the U.S. And that's actually new to the Nexus because it's the single device that runs on all networks, which is pretty cool for a relatively low price. So if you like this video, please thumbs up it. Let me know what you think about this tablet. Is there something else you like? I know that Asus has a couple other versions that are built off the Nexus line, but is not a Nexus-branded tablet. That's actually cheaper. What do you guys think about that? And of course, subscribe and watch more of my videos. Thanks. Bye.